Party people, what's going on? This is Austin. I'm out here on my boss's property here in Marengo, Wisconsin. Oh, these trails are so icy. And I'm trying to find a large enough popple tree that I can down and make some canoe paddles out of. So the difficulty with doing this kind of thing is I live next to an enormous, trails are super icy. I live next to an enormous national forest up here, but getting permits to cut down anything in the national forest, from all that I know, is a pain in the rear. And if I can avoid it, I really want to, but I'm seeing some more mature stuff here, so we'll walk back and see what we can see. All right, so there's two things right now. I'm not finding anything with a broad enough diameter that I want to take down. And the second thing is that this underbrush is super thick. So anything that I chop down in here, I gotta frickin' get out of here. Which doesn't sound like a whole lot of fun right now. But yeah, there's just briars and thorns. So, gonna move on and see what else I can find. Alrighty, guys. So, I'm out here on the property, and this road here runs east and west, and I was told I could get anything here on the south side of the road, and that all the property on the north side of the road, they don't have rights to. Reservation treaties and weird stuff like that. So there's an Indian, an Ojibwe, Superior Ojibwe tribe up here, or band up here. So, dude, there's some trees. There's loads of mature trees like on the north side of this road, but I saw one really good mature tree, but it was just going to be too, once I got it down, it was just going to be too big of a pain in the rear to get back to the car. So I'm walking the road and kind of seeing what I can see from along the road, and hopefully I can find something. So wish me luck. Oh, here's something kind of cool. This is why I love the winter time around here, is you can see all the tracks. Looks like some turkey tracks heading back and forth across the road through either side of the woods. So beautiful time of the year to be up here. Wish me luck in my tree hunting. So let you know what I find. So you can see this gully here along the edge of the road. One thing you have to be super careful about here in the winter time, and especially how the weather has been through here right now, but one thing that you have to be super mindful of is that a lot of these little gullies and swamps like don't ever drain water. So, and a lot of this grass here like might look like it's just snow-packed grass, when in reality there's probably like a creek, and it's not even a creek, it's just standing water. And right now the weather has been really warm, so any ice that's on top of this is more than likely is more than likely gonna break. So, I mean, you're not gonna end up to your neck in water or anything like that, but, you know, if you don't wanna get, like, freezing cold feet and you don't have waterproof boots on, like I don't right now, I'm just out in some work boots, you have to be careful of all that. So, pro tip. Alright, so this tree here, I don't know, I'm going to venture to say that it's probably about 23 inches in diameter, or in, I should say in circumference. Let me look. So I'm going to hang you from around my neck right now. This is like ghetto GoPro, right? And so what I came up with earlier today was I took this piece of twine, and it's a 55 inch piece of twine, 36 inches, can you see there, at 36 inches there's a knot in it, and the math would tell me that 36 inch, yeah, that's like, that tree is probably not even, let me drop it so it's in the field of view. Okay, so what I did is this cord here in my hands is 55 inches long, and so I tied up a knot right there, if you can see it, at 36 inches. So, and 31 inches is a 10 inch diameter tree. So 36 is probably closer to like 11 and a half to 12 inch diameter tree. And I need something that's, well, way bigger than this. So, and the problem is that with a canoe paddle, you know, most of the paddle is very narrow in the handle, but it's all, if I'm making a one piece, so if I'm making a one piece canoe paddle and I'm going to do it kind of the old school way, I need that broad, I need that broad diameter so that I can make the head or the head of the paddle. So the one that I've measured is like 8 inches, and I don't know. Let's keep walking a little bit and see what else I can find, but I've already circled back on where I've been through. A little discouraging. So this is what I'm worried about, are these little channels here, and with the snow you can't really tell that water settled in here, but I already stepped in that, and there's probably about 3 inches of water underneath. And so generally what I find is the best thing to do is to walk back up where along here, keep close to the grass, and then what I'm going to try to do is cross over here where there's lots of grass, and I can at least step on the grass if there's water here. All right, so I found a tree big enough that's along this trail here, but it's snowmobiled. And God, I'm actually kind of discouraged. Because I was hoping that this would be far easier than it's proven to be. But I'm just not finding any luck on this little piece of property. What is this back here? None of these are big enough. So, as I take you off from around my neck, I'm super discouraged because just been wanting to, you know, work on this paddle making And I don't know, I thought that I thought this was going to be the easiest part, you know, coming out and finding a big old tree and cutting it down. But the thing about this, thing about all this land up here is that so much of this was logged, and has been logged multiple times over the last century. So most of the trees on this property are not at all old growth, or most of this is very young soft trees, probably, I would venture to say that all of this is probably less than 25 years old, maybe 30 years old, at least on this parcel of land. So here's something that looks promising. Let's see what's up this way. See that tree back there? Do you see that tree right there? That, kids, may just be big enough. And as much as I would like to get more than one paddle out of it, I think it will be big enough to at least get one. So here's my little sheet, my knot tape measure that you totally can't see. This is kind of what happens when you don't have some like super cool amigo that comes out and films you doing your cool shit in the woods. So anyway, it's still short, but okay. I just don't feel like I can ethically take something that I may end up not using at all, but check out that sunset, eh? Where's the focus? Let me walk out to the clear. I mean, you know, this is, if I don't get a tree, man, would you check that out? Beautiful deep red sunset. I'll take in and throw in a couple of still photos right after this. Alright, so I'm gonna walk this trail a little further and see if I can get lucky with finding something. I'm finding some other mature trees here. I don't know if you can see this one here that comes up in forks like this in the back right here. This one, it's more mature than the popple, but I don't know what it is. I know quite a bit of the trees and how to identify them around here, but there's so many that you run into that even they don't even fit their book description. Like I've seen trees that, you know, they don't match their book description at all, which can be really like frustrating when you have an identification book and you're sitting there and you're like, wait, this is sitting next to a dozen other popple trees, but why is it not? How can this not be a popple? And then there's the odd occasion that it just isn't. See these here? This stand of aspen or popple. And none of these are big enough. Well, guys, I think the lesson learned today is that sometimes these projects don't turn out to be easy at all in any shape of the term easy, you know? I don't like to throw my opinions on people, but I think the really important thing about doing these kinds of projects where you're taking from the land is you have to be ethical about it. You know, I have to be willing to use most of the material that I'm going to take. And if I'm going to take it, I have to definitely make sure that I'm going to use it and not just let it sit. Because I know people that have, you know, they've gone and cut down. I just don't want to get back there. You know, they've gone and cut down trees for some reason or another. They have a project or something that they think that they're going to use it for. Or a lot of times people, they get this notion that they're going to be like, they're going to craft. Kind of saw something on Pinterest and I want birch wood. You see lots of birch wood on those Pinterest projects. And, you know, people take things and with no true commitment to using them. So, to me, the most important thing is that if I'm going to come out here, I have to know that what I'm going to take from the land, I'm going to use as much of it as I can. Yeah, I mean, I'm just, you know, you kind of, I wouldn't like to say that I have a keen eye for the outdoors, but I mean, I notice that I see the outdoors in a different way after having spent quite a bit of time out in places like this. And you know, what you notice is that you begin to see things much faster. So, you know, like I can go through the woods. These snowmobile trails. I don't know if I should be blaming the snowmobile trails or my poor choice of footwear. Probably both. But you know, you come out to woods like this and I can immediately look through the woods and just eyeball not what I want. And didn't save myself that time. And I didn't even have a glove on. Shit. But that's the second time in 2 days I've fallen. But yesterday I was on my bike. As I was saying, you know, you can look through the woods and see things in a way that you didn't before. So if you have ever wanted to get out into the woods and you just haven't committed to the time to do it, I would highly encourage you to do so. But it's funny when you come out to people's property like this, because right back there is a boat. A boat that's probably been back there for 20 years. But, and you know, that's kind of another thing is I work for people that maybe don't necessarily see the obligation that I feel that I have to, to be a steward of the land. And that's not to say that they aren't people that have, oh my Lord, don't tell me I walked straight by that. Oh my goodness. Guys, is that two trees or one? Tell me it's one. Nope. One. I'm sorry, it's two trees. I saw the trunk here of this one joined up with the trunk of the other one and thought it was a big old tree. But it ain't. It's just like all the other ones I've seen. So, but as I was saying, you know, people have different values for stewardship of land, and I think people that live out here see things differently than I do. You know, I grew up in the city. I live in a small town now, but, you know, I live right in town, and politics in every way, but especially about the outdoors, is, you know, you can't seem to have a conversation with people about anything that you agree about, and I think it's really important to sometimes suck up your pride and have conversations about what you agree about. Or at least be willing to find what it is that you agree with people on. And, you know, I have probably been guilty too often of just kind of claiming the middle and just sitting there. But, you know, me kind of liking to sit in the middle, I think kind of comes from my travels. You know, I've met people that really don't like where I come from and where and what my country has done or, you know, has been a part of, and, you know, I have to kind of make a way for myself in those situations where, you know, people realize that I'm not necessarily on board with all the things that my, you know, that everyone else, and not everyone else that I'm, you know, that where I'm from is on board with the things that have gone on, but, you know, so when you meet people or you talk outdoors or outdoor politics, I think it's important to find what you can agree upon. And then you might be surprised just how much you agree with them. I think that's kind of vague, and I kind of meant to keep it vague. But anyway, all this here is, there's nothing that I want to take, and I'm going to have to go and find another friend that I know of and ask if I can go scout their property. But guys, thanks for coming along and being with me on my little walk in the woods. Don't forget to subscribe if you like what you're seeing, and we'll hopefully be back with a video with some more action and some more outdoors, some more woodcrafting kind of stuff, axe swinging and saws and all that. But check this out, look at all of these right here. This is what I wanted to do, is drive the car right down this road, post up on the other side of the ditch and take down one of those trees, but it's going to be that easy for me. Sorry, I bet the wind noise is awful.